Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Explosive offenses on virtually every campus in the Pac-12. Time to establish a little pecking order with this early season matchup in the Pac-12. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
As a memoriam to fallen soldiers of World War I, Memorial Stadium's the site for today's game. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. Taken down by the kicker. Roach's overall ability, Herbie, has got to drive you crazy if you're a defensive coach.
Yeah, you look at a defensive coordinator trying to slow this guy down, it's next to impossible. He can do so many different things, and today they got to try to put pressure on him, because if you sit back, he just makes too many things happen.
Goes incomplete, intended for his wideouts. The Trojans always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. From their own 29-yard line, second down. Throws complete, he's got space to work. And he's leveled to the 38-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
Got some open field. He's at midfield, and they push him out at the 49.
The play was very well conceived as they were able to get a decent gain and a first down.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Got a man, watch out here. He's at the 40, and they make the stop at the 35-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
He steps out at the 30.
That brings him second and five.
Quick throw, and he's tackled at about the 29-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
He's got it with room to run. He's knocked out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
I like how the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive, and you just want to get the ball in his hands.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Down.
get to that quickly. Tackle made around the 2-yard line. Hill's the kind of impact player that every team in the country would love to have on their team. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition.
Touchdown, Southern Cal.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Time to go to the Little Apple in Manhattan. And for Kansas State, they've dropped two straight. Memphis grabs the W by a touchdown. In other games, the Hawkeyes were ranked 24th. Now the loss is likely to knock them out of the polls. This game was so tight, every play seemed to be of the utmost importance. The Demon Deacons get the win, 28-21.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Thomas sets a return.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. The halfback with a carry. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 4 along the way. That makes it second and 6.
Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 29-yard line. Feeds it to the back. And he hits him hard at the 32-yard line.
If the back was his first option, but he got in the ball and he was able to make something big happen.
And down he goes around the 44-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 8.
So we're looking at another third down here. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Excellent job here by the defense to sniff that one out before it turned into a first down.
Allen is waiting for the snap. Tackle made at the 32. The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
USC is up a score. Tackle at the 42-yard line.
Gain of 10 on the play. First down.
Now he tries to buy some time. He wants it all. And it's the senior. and he's taken down at about the 13.
What great time to go with the play action. Defense was anticipating run. They came up to stop the ball carrier. The quarterback was able to find his receiver downfield. He makes a big-time play and a great catch for a first down.
He's taken down around the 3-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Trojans. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
He makes the PAT. A 5-play, 68-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
King has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Estes has it at the 5, and they fall on the loose ball. Tackle at the 25-yard line. Trojans have found a way to shut this offense down, but hey, it's still early in a football game.
Yeah, give them a lot of credit for the way they've played up to this point, but just based on watching these teams and preparing for this game, you'd not be surprised to see this offense eventually find itself and start to execute much better.
First and 10, ball on the 25. Decent run here, right side.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
As we change ends of the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. USC's lead is 2 touchdowns. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. And they get the sack.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Allen is the punter. He makes it out to midfield. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Slings it out there incomplete. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
From midfield, it's second down. Just throws this one away. Intended target. So the stop there on third and long, and that's going to bring up a punting situation.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Fry to punt. And he can't hang on to the ball.
Well, that's exactly what happens when you take your eyes off the ball.
Concentration for return man is of the utmost importance.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Brought down at the 25.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Second and long. Ball on the 20. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Love gained 7 yards on that play.
Well, that's one effective way to slow these guys down, getting a hand between the ball and the receiver.
Allen awaits the snap. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. USC's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line. Setback.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Estes, the return man. Fielded at the 19. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Catch it. He's got nowhere to go. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Blue 14.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
Martin was the intended receiver on the play.
And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop at about the 43-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 35.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, better get back to that drawing board, because these defensive ends are just too quick.
There's a strike complete, and he's tackled right away. Wow, a long gain, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
Whoa, he just took a licking. The Trojans are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
It was a quick three and out on their last possession. Gets it. He's in space. He's pushed out of bounds.
Around the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Here's a quick throw. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
First down.
First and 10, ball on the 45. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Good tackle there in space. USC will take their second time out of the half. From the 40-yard line, third down. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 21-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 19 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Pass to the end zone. Touchdown, USC. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. He splits the uprights with the extra point. King has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Excellent kick from his own goal line. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Yard line. Great effort by this kid to get in there and make the sack.
This defensive end has provided a very efficient pass rush. One of the keys to this game was for him to get to the quarterback, and he has really done that today.
from their own 18-yard line. It's third down. No surprises here as we come to the end of the first half. The Trojans with a 3-touchdown advantage.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both of these defenses are opportunistic. They're very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. We've got a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We've got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Am I stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Thomas sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. USC's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Ready! Green 88! Green!
Throwing right. Incomplete pass.
Number 84, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Caught and big hit there to stop him.
Harris makes the tackle at the 28-yard line. That makes it third and 7.
Rifles this one out to the left.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Fourth down.
Allen is waiting for the snap. And he's tackled at the 50. Pretty good job by the return man there. They're ready to begin another drive. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From the 50, second down. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Throws to the tailback, incomplete.
Number 22 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes
from the 30-yard line, second down.
97 to the mic.
He He's got it out to his tight end. And down he goes at the 18.
Gain of 12 yards. First down.
Touchdown. Wow, an almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for six.
Yep, the defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
And he adds the extra point. USC to kick. He's to the 20. He got hit hard. Roach has kept his cool after a bad first half, Kirk, and they're right in this thing.
You know, even when his team was down, he just never seemed to panic. He was cool in the huddle. He got his teammates on the same page and has really just taken command of this offense. I think he's been unbelievable, and his talent, I think, is through the roof. But I think it's his mental toughness is what really puts him into a category all by himself.
He's taken down around the 36-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Throws it out there. This one is incomplete. So the referee is going to take a look at several angles. Now remember, he's seeing the same thing we are, and he needs indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. Well, I think he came down with it, but from up in the booth, it's hard to tell.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the call on the field will be reversed. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49.
Roger, Roger.
He's under some heat. And he's hit immediately.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. Quick throw, incomplete. One of his receiver. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 37. They'll make the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Throws it deep. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Number 84 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. USC in control. Tackle around the 18-yard line. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. Throwing left. He's tackled around the 42-yard line. We've got a first and 10.
Ball on their own 42.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
To the receiver, incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. Punt. He dropped it.
He was definitely peeking to see what kind of space he had to run. And that loss of focus is what cost him.
That return man is lucky that his team got the ball back, or he would have heard an earful from the coach. Actually, he probably will anyway. I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. And he had some steam on that throw. Brought down at the 43. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
From their own 43-yard line, it's second down.
Set, cut.
Wants to throw outside. Oh, great catch. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Flips it middle to the running back. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line.
Harris on the tackle at the 33-yard line. That'll make it second and seven.
Quick strike and he drops it.
Thomas was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it
third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Complete.
That brings us up to 7.
Got a man wide open and it goes through his hands.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
9 times out of 10, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. We're about set to start things up again.
Three down.
USC looking to put this game away if they score here. And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33. And they make the stop at the 35-yard line.
Gain 2 yards.
under pressure,
and he's level at the 27-yard line.
Man, it's an offensive lineman. This is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
That's three down and one to go. The Trojans are up big. Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. Gets to about the 47-yard line. This defensive end is having a very good day.
Well, he's a physical force. You know, when he puts those big meat hooks on you, there's only one direction and one speed that you can go, and that is down and quickly. Guy has three sacks. You've got to do something to slow him down. I would suggest a chip run. Use a tight end to stay in to help out, maybe a running back. Anything you can do to try to create any kind of confusion for this defender is something that's going to help you out.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Halfback's got it on the quick throw, and he's taken down at the 39-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Made around the 26-yard line. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle, and he's tackled at the 16. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Clipping. Offense.
Got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
It's first down and a lot. They come out in an empty backfield. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Nice play to set up first and goal.
Inside the 5-yard line. Defense took away the quarterback, a great read, and the tailback ends up in the end zone for the touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 5-play, 37-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's taken down at the 41-yard line.
California's defense has not played up to their hype, that's for sure.
One thing you can always count on from this team is a great defensive performance. I think you and I and everybody today got to be shocked to see these guys, how bad they've played on that side of the football.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Shakes off a tackle. Gets out to around the 32. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9.
That'll make it second and inches.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he tackles him hard at the 19.
At the 19-yard line. First down.
Here's an opening. And he's tackled after positive yardage. So he holds on to it and gets a good 5 yards.
That brings him second and five.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. He goes out of bounds around the 10-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it third
and one. Let's go, defense. And here we go. Check three.
That's a great tackle at the one.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
And he is drilled at the 3-yard line. It's second and goal. Ball on the 3. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. There's another. Clock keeper, just keep it moving for Kirk and I, will you? We want to get out of here. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
Atlantic Coast Conference action in the spotlight. And for Washington, he rings up 3 touchdowns through the air. The Volunteers walk out with a 7-point win.
Reese, we're not going to have an exciting finish here, I can tell you that. King looks ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 36. Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. Under a minute left. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 36. The 46. They complete the slant. Good for 10.
Well, the receiver does a nice job on his route. And how about the throw by the quarterback? Perfect execution. And when those two things are going well, the offense has a good chance of picking up big yards.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. So on third down, they come away with a first down on the option play.
Third and short, and the defense almost had them stopped. But the offense got just enough to move the chains.
Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. It's second and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Fires back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in. Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but it's a blowout. It has been for most of the game. I think it's time for everybody to go. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. It's a short kick. The Trojans coaching staff stuck to their game plan. It worked.
And give them a lot of credit for coming up with a plan where they knew they could find ways to get him the football. Even with all the recognition and defense being concerned about him, they came up with that plan, and this young man delivered.
We have less than a minute to go. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. And the ball game's over, and our final score in this one, USC 35, California 7. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kurt?
Well, this is no big surprise. I think we all anticipated a severe beating in this one. California really had their work cut out for themselves today, and they just weren't able to get it done. They just didn't have the firepower to match up with the talented athletes on the other side of the ball.
Things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.